Having your own blog as a developer is a great idea. Your first instinct might be to code and build your own blog from scratch, and not use some ready-made blogging solution such as WordPress or Medium, for instance. This is very tempting, and when I first started my blog, I had the exact same idea. But if your goal is to build a successful blog and become good at blogging, this might not be the best idea. And in this video, I want to share you my thoughts on why you should not build your own blog when you are starting out blogging. When first starting out blogging, the most important thing to do is to start writing articles, period. Especially if you are a beginner writer, you don't know yet how to write articles, so you need practice. More you write, the better your articles will get as you learn how to write. So it's crucial to write as much as you can. So what happens if you start coding your blog from scratch? All your time and energy is put into making the blog instead of writing the articles on your blog. So you are not actually concentrating on getting better at blogging and getting your articles out there, which should be your first priority. I have been writing my blog for over 3 years now, and I've noticed that the hardest thing to do is always to get started. When I first started, I set up my blog on top of WordPress. This was fast and easy, and I didn't have to worry about if the site was working or not, and I could only concentrate on writing my articles. Now, after blogging for a few years, I actually decided to update my blog and ended up coding it myself from scratch. But if I had started to code my own blog back when I started out blogging, I think I wouldn't be here today. I'm not saying that as a beginner blogger, it's not possible to code your own blog and be a successful blogger. I just know that especially in the beginning, just to starting to write an article is hard. Not to mention if you have to worry about your blog website functioning or not. And as a developer, you are probably more tempted to write code than you are writing articles. So it's a big distraction and way to procrastinate if you can code your own blog instead of writing articles on it. And you are kind of fooling yourself that you are actually working on my blog when you are coding it instead of writing the articles. So if I didn't have a blog and I was starting my blog today, here's what I would do. First of all, as you might guess, I wouldn't code it myself, and instead I would use some easy to set up ready-made blogging solution. I would probably build my blog on top of WordPress because it's a super popular blogging platform and it's easy and fast to set up. This way you can also host your blog under your own domain. I know WordPress has its downsides, but in my opinion, for beginner bloggers, the pros outweigh the cons, and it is still a good starting point, especially if you want to own your own traffic, so to say, instead of using something like Medium or DevTool. So next, I would buy hosting for my blog, and I would do it from Bluehost. I used Bluehost when I first started out blogging, and I really liked it. I just checked and they still offer some great benefits. They, for example, offer free SSL certificate, free domain name for first year, which is great because you get your blog under your own domain name, which is important. And they also offer one-click install for WordPress, so it's super easy, super fast to set up your blog. I'll leave a link below so you can check out all that stuff, but if you're not feeling like putting down money for setting up your blog, you can always start your blog by using some of the blogging platforms for free. Some of these are, for example, medium.com, DevTool, or Hasnode. These are also good options because you don't need any setup, you just make an account and you can start writing. The biggest downside with these options is though that you don't own your content. And what I mean by this is, for example, if you write articles to Medium and Medium shuts down or decides to delete or ban your articles, there is not much you can do. So in my opinion, having your content on your own blog, if it was WordPress or something else, but that you own the domain and host your own blog, that's always better in the long run. And the final step for all this is to write articles. After the blog is set up, just write as many articles as you can. If you are a beginner blogger and your goal is to build a successful blog and get better at writing articles to your blog, I wouldn't reinvent the wheel when it comes to building the blog. Use one of the ready-made solutions, either Bluehost plus WordPress or DevTools or Medium or Hasnode, and just set up your blog fast and easily and start writing articles to your blog. And remember, you can always update your blog and build it from scratch in the future if you wish, but the most important thing is to get down the habit of writing. If you like this video, please hit the like button below, it really helps out, and subscribe if you are not already. And next, do check out this video over here.